Sgt. Pepper's changed a lot about the way musicians were treated, how they were seen, and also how albums were made. Fill in the blanks.
When Sgt. Pepper came out, it really just altered the idea of how people thought about rock musicians. You know, there was a sense of, it was a serious bid for, you know, bands like the Beatles and certainly the Rolling Stones and, you know, Bob Dylan, of course, you know, to be perceived as artists. You know, the music industry was driven by singles, you know, pretty much up to that point. And, you know, that was great, but there was a kind of sense, oh, okay, you had a hit last month, okay, what's your next song? Whereas, like, the Beatles went off the road and decided that they were going to work in the studio. And they took full advantage of that. And when Sgt. Pepper dropped, it was just cataclysmic. It was really, it was the soundtrack for what became the Summer of Love. And in many ways, it was the... It was the kind of anthem of the Summer of Love.
What would you think if I sang out a tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me?
The song spoke to what was going on culturally.
Completely, yeah. Well, you know, there was a generational dividing line also. You know, that was those were the days of, you know, don't trust anyone over 30. And, you know, there was a sense of, you know, psychedelic drugs beginning to come on the scene. And, you know, by the second song, when you get up to a line like, I get high with a little help from my friends, I mean, the Beatles stating that so directly in a song on one of their records was massive. I mean, nobody blinks an eye at that now, but it was just like, oh, okay, like they're on our side.
Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds, yeah, LSD.
And then there's so many other references on the record. It was really a sense of, you know, this kind of language sounds silly now, but, you know, there was a sense of, it was like envisioning a utopia. You know, there was a real sense that a kind of revolution of consciousness was taking place, and Sgt. Pepper became the soundtrack for that.
Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds.
Another thing I think is interesting about the album, and you really don't see it now very much, is the idea of listening to an album in its entirety.
Completely.
Right?
Oh, absolutely. And I think that's, you know, it's become fashionable among critics, certainly, to kind of over the years poo-poo Sgt. Pepper a little bit. You're like, oh, I prefer Revolver or I prefer Rubber Soul. And I get that. I mean, those are great records. But when you're assessing an album's importance or whether or not it's the best, well, those records were great, but they did not alter the culture. Sgt. Pepper altered the culture. And one of the ways in which it did is that it's very much of a piece, you know, a concept album. For example, they had released Strawberry Fields and Penny Lane just a few months before. And it's often asked, yeah, well, why wasn't that on the album? Well, that would have been, I think, in the Beatles' minds, a kind of step back. You know, before Sgt. Pepper's, albums often were, oh, okay, you had a hit single, now make, you know, 10 other songs, we'll put the hit single on and that will sell as an album. Whereas the Beatles didn't want to do that. It's like, well, we put out those songs, people got them, but now Sgt. Pepper is going to be completely new. And that was part of its impact. It sounded so fresh.
Is there one song on the album you feel is important or is one that made a real difference in terms of the way music moved forward?
I think A Day in the Life was something that was just completely different.
I read the news today, oh boy, about a lucky man who made the grave.
It's a brilliant kind of collaboration between Lennon and McCartney. Lennon kind of documenting the kind of meanderings of his own mind on this, a friend of his who had died, you know, these kind of little news items. But at the same time, you know, you have a sense of seen from the perspective of like a young person at that time, just like somehow all of this is going to disappear, you know, and we're going to enter a new age. That song conveys that very powerfully, I think.
Tell us a little bit about the significance of this being a record that signaled that the Beatles weren't going to tour anymore.
So the Beatles saying, you know, we go to play our shows, people are screaming all the time, they're not listening to the music, we can barely hear ourselves, we're going to go into the studio. You know, that really upped the stakes for them. You know, it was a daring move, and it also, you know, created a, okay, well, what are you going to come up with then if you're going to be focusing so much on this kind of private world? And it was very interesting because Sgt. Pepper, of course, opens with sounds of crowds listening to a band. It's almost like they're kind of recreating in some sense, the communality of a live performance, except in the studio.
It was 20 years ago today. Sergeant Pepper taught the band to play. They've been going in and out of style. But the guarantee to raise a smile.
If they just went in, you know, and thought, well, we'll be back touring again. Let's play some songs we could play on the road. That was one of the things. The songs on Sgt. Pepper, with all the orchestrations, certainly back then, would have been virtually impossible to play live.
It's getting better all the time.
John, Paul, George, and Ringo were in their 20s when they made this album. The surviving members are in their 70s now. Does Sgt. Pepper still hold up?
Yeah, absolutely. When you hear the album now, it still packs a lot of power, you know? If you take the time to listen to it, it's transporting, and it's meant to be a journey. And, you know, when you start with the Sgt. Pepper theme and you end with A Day in the Life, you know, by the time you get there, you really feel like you have journeyed, you've taken a trip. And I think the Beatles very consciously intended that.
Anthony DeCurtis, thanks for being with us.
It was a great pleasure, Alison.